Yeah, I've been the timer.
Okay. Toastmaster Karthikeyan, storyteller. Storyteller Toastmaster Karthikeyan, over to you.
Our dreams are a reflection of our unconscious mind, our desires, our ambitions, and whatever goes on around us. All these elements are mixed, matched, and compounded together to give you a series of random but somehow understandable events to which we know as our dreams. But however, once we wake up, we will not be able to remember a single issue, which I find really, beautiful at the same time, really funny. Take it for this instance. I remember a time when I was dreaming that I had just won the war and I was about to save my crush and defeat the villain at the same time when bam, the alarm rings. It's really unpleasant for me, but I knew that by the time I woke up, hit the snooze button, and went back to sleep, I wouldn't be able to recreate that same moment again. And no matter how many times I tried, believe me, I tried because I really wanted to get back that moment. My maturity grew, and finally, here standing before you is Mr. Pragmatic. And so, being the pragmatic individual I am, I noticed that it's rather better if I gave to you the true self rather than a made-up self. Because it's while writing the speech also, I noticed that it felt easier to write about the true events which has occurred rather than making up new events. Because why? Dreams actually reveal the true self, what true desires you actually want. And with a pinch of masala. So here I am trying to give you the real unfiltered side of me to you guys. So gather around the fireplace or your Zoom accounts and let me tell you my tale. So let me give you context. This occurred right after my 12-7 mock exams. I had performed really poorly. I ate and I decided to sleep. And out of nowhere, my spiritual guru, Nesamani, Mr. Vadivelu, came in front to me and said in a thunderous voice, as I noticed myself meditating under the volcano, under a waterfall surrounded by volcanoes, with a Tamil Bijam playing in the background, saying, "You are a blank piece of paper." Let's assume the second or the third page, because that symbolizes me beginning into the stage called adulthood. The first page talks about my childhood, of which I'm really grateful for its value system. It is important because without it, I wouldn't be where I am today. Moving back, the blank page, this symbolizes you have potential. And at the same time, you have no accolades. You can take into people's, you take into consideration everyone's criticism. You have no ready results. But however, you and will be sculpted, painted, and with each and every tool in your disposal by you and the world around you. And this is a true fact, because after watching Doom 3, I decided to race all around the mall as my parents chased me behind. Seriously, what is in front of me, even something fleeting or something soul inspiring or something permanent can and will change you. I've noticed many things have played many important roles in my life. There are many instances of these things. And believe me, without these instances, I will not be who I am today. If I wanted to be, he continued, you want to be an F1 driver who runs, who rules the world. You want to be a football magician on the field. You want to lead a gully cricket team to glory. Just do it. The world will throw obstacles in front of you. The world also give you gifts. You must cherish each and every small gift which is given to you. The first time it went on the EMUs, which you see traveling around the city, which I fondly call the green train, the joy which I received from that, it's been quite some time since I've received that joy too. But it taught me one thing. Whatever I receive, I should enjoy that. And I've brought it in, taken that into my life even up till this date. The world will challenge you, but you must remember to stay strong, and you must move forward. You are not completed. You are an unfinished piece of art, but that is a part of your beauty too. You are you. And this particular line is what I remember listening from a very my mentor of mine, who I still regard warmly to this day, because he told me that this is the best thing which you can keep in mind, because without this, you will feel something's left missing. I've also noticed that whatever happens, it is basically you who's telling yourself to do who's telling yourself to get back on your feet. Because it is, in a sense, a dream is nothing but you, which you're trying to tell yourself, which you generally cannot tell in normal circumstances. It is you who wants you to get up on your feet. And so, after getting up, I sat down, continued my work. I remembered all the times I'd gone down, all the times I'd gotten back up, all my famous joys, winning the tournaments, playing, going out with my friends, all the times where I had been knocked down, but I got back up. And now I'm here in front of you, now knowing that I can go into a good college with all joys around me. There were many things which I wanted to happen. It didn't. But I'm just going to take it into my stride and move forward. So, hey, I'm Karthikeyan. Nice to meet you.